All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. We're going to keep the action rolling here at Hardcore Arena. Dropping down to the junior welterweight division. This next fight, 3 by 2 rounds, and of course, full tie rules. Proudly sponsored by Line Studio. Coming to us first out of the blue corner, trained out of ACSA, with the wonderful Philip Lay in the corner. 3 fights for 3 wins. Please welcome Braden Sam.
Braden Sam is making his walkout. Just imagine what these boys are feeling and thinking. I mean, 3 fights, 3 wins. You know, the nerves are in there, but they look very, very calm and relaxed. It's good to see these boys up and coming. And this is what the sport's all about, trained by a great man himself, Phil Lay.
And his opponent fighting out of the red corner with also an undefeated record of 2 fights for 2 wins, weighing in at 62.5 kilograms. Trained by Chris Cortez out of Strike Studio, Dylan Bartillo.
Now we see Dylan Bartolo, Strike Studio, trained by Chris Cortez, making his way out to center ring.
Bold tolls, your referee in charge, Abbas Ahmadi. Both fighters, Waku Ramoy.
As the boys make their way around the ring, the best of the ring doing the Waku. Like we said, we've got a great lineup of 14 fights tonight. Fight number 2 is proudly sponsored by Line Studio.
One great thing when we see a fight like this coming up, ladies and gentlemen, is one of these fighters, the O has to go. We have Philip Lay, 3 fights, 3 wins. Also coming up against Dylan Bartolo, 2 fights, 2 wins. Who's going to remain undefeated in this one?
Well, they've both got a perfect record there, and I don't think these fighters are going to be looking at who's going to maintain the clean record. I think they've got a job to do, and you know their trainers will be advising them on how to do it and what and so forth. So I think these boys are probably just going out there, give it the best shot and really just turn it on and come home with the win.
And speaking of the trainers, how about these two guys? You've got Philip Lay out of the blue corner and Chris Cortez as a trainer for Dylan Bartolo, the red corner. Two fantastic guys. It really goes to show the standard of Thai boxing that is present in Victoria.
Oh, look, I think the Thai boxing in Victoria has come a long way, and I think these two trainers have been around for a very, very long time. So I do believe these fighters are in great hands.
We're just going through a couple of things with the officials of Mark Cook. Bit of paperwork being thrown around. But we look like we are...
Oh, they're changing corners. I think there's been a bit of confusion there.
Wow. Okay.
I know they're starting to confuse us over here now. Yeah. That happens. Don't forget. Fight number 2 is proudly sponsored by Lion Studio. Thanks to all the sponsors for tonight. About these guys, these shows will be very hard to put on.
Okay, so... I can see Chris Cortez over in the blue corner, but Dylan is wearing the red shorts, so a little bit of confusion, but hey, this is Fight Sports, the fans have come to see it, and we're ready to rumble.
It's a great turnout tonight at the Ultima Function Centre. Great job, great work by Mark, Chelsea, and all the team at Hardcore Promotions.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, we are seconds out. For round 1.
And Here we go, the start of fight number two, round one.
Nice kicking exchange straight out of the blocks of these two. Bade and Sam really looking to rip some of those kicks in there. But Jesus, getting a reply from Dylan Bartolo.
How clean are these two boys with such a, you know, a three-fight piece?
Absolutely. Like I said, it just goes to, it really is an accreditation to the trainers that they have in their corner. You know, the standard, not just in Victoria, but around Australia, it's really getting high.
Exchanging those kicks, you can hear the thumping from over here.
Oh, they're just ripping them in, smashing the arms as they tie up over in the neutral side of the ring.
Both boys in the grapple now trying to work the knees.
A very well-experienced Muay Thai man himself, as both the fighter and the referee are Basamardi in centre ring. Oh, the elbows are starting to be thrown. They're not mucking around. This is how we roll at Hardcore Promotions. As well, fight fans, coming up on June 26th is another Ultima Function Centre Hardcore Promotions. We got Joe Churakvit taking on the Cowboy, Corey Smith. Great to see the Cowboy back in centre ring.
What a great opening round to fight number two. Both boys really exchanging it. You can see all the red marks on Graded, is it? In the red shorts?
Yeah, the bit more of the fairer skin.
Fairer skin. The other guy. Well, like, I'm getting a little bit confused because I swapped corners, so I'm getting a little bit confused over here. I just see Braden coming in with that left hand straight directly down the center.
Oh, nice. Bit of a fake and uppercut there off the rear hand from Braden Sam as they tie up over in the blue corner, which is now actually Dylan Bartolo's corner. I know a bit of a confusion thing there, folks, but nevertheless, the boys are throwing down.
And that's the end of round one.
End of round one, ladies and gentlemen. This fight proudly sponsored by Live Studios.
And there we go, the end of round one. I think both fighters came out very, very hard. But their technique and their style was, you know what, you would not think that these guys had only had two or three fights apiece. You would think they were the caliber of maybe 10 to 12, 15 fights.
Absolutely, Joe. There's not a lot in it. I mean, I'd probably almost sit on the fence for that one. You know, a 10 all round. Were you leaning one way or the other yourself?
Look, I'm with you, John. I can't pick it. I think it was a little bit of a tough one to pick. But, you know, we'll see how the judges go later on and what they decide.
That's one thing I love with Thai boxing, when they get into a bit of a kick fest. Anything you can do, well, I can do better.
Yeah, it's always kick for kick, or punch for punch, elbow for elbow, knee for knee.
Fighters, seconds out. For round two.
And here we go to start of round two. Braden comes out very strong with his hands, trying to push forward, a nice body rip. Have a look at the exchange of these two guys. No one's backing off. They're both just standing in exchange, and whatever you can give me, I'll give you back even harder. And that's what it's all about. It's great to see these two young boys going for it.
Stand your ground, walk forward, and throw down. That's what Thai boxing's all about.
And that's so true there, Jono. Both yours, you know, both boys are really using every possible skill they have, but they're using it so good. Elbows are exchanging. Nice body kick there.
Oh, Dylan looking. I thought he's going to throw the spinning elbow there, but he decided to opt out of it. Going for the low punches, missing altogether, but trying to find that kick again. Nicely checked. Braden Sam standing his ground, starting to creep forward, switching up nicely to the body, but return with the old 1-2 from Dylan Bartolo.
Comes the elbows there.
Now, the clinch game for those watching at home, it's all about, it's an art form. It's about patience and looking for those little things. Because a clinch game can easily turn very nasty very quickly if you make that slight wrong mistake.
Oh, you got to be very careful. You get cut there. You need to talk. Oh. There goes the knockdown. Was that a knockdown? I missed that.
Nah, not a knockdown. He just swept his leg out. We had Dylan going for the big bombing elbow, and Braden was very sneaky at kicking out the supporting leg.
If you have a look at both boys, they don't really pull back, or, you know, they're not very shy. They're not shy. Like, I was just standing in exchange, or whatever you can give me, I'll just give you one back. As you can see there, knee for knee, throws the elbow.
The sneaky elbows are coming in. Braden's starting to get on top, and a nice rear straight left from Dylan Bartolo. He's actually landed that a few times. As the boys tie up once again, Our very experienced referee, Abbas Amadi, breaks the boys. He'll bring them into center ring and we'll get this one resumed as we count down to the final stages of round number two.
End of round two. Graydon Sam, Dylan Matola on Centrelink, proudly supported, sponsored by Line Studio.
Once again, Joe, do you lean anyway on that one? Myself, I'll probably just sneak that one too. Well, now it is the red corner in the blue shorts. That would be great, and Sam.
Look, I still think I can't pick on this one as well. I think it's very, very close. But I'd like to see what happens in the third round. I like to think that both boys are pretty even and fair at the moment. And let them come out in the third round and really exchange blows and see who's going to take home with it.
100%. It is up for the taking. These boys are definitely up in the aggressive meter. We're going to the third and final round.
Now we're waiting for the trainers to see what kind of advice they're going to give their fighters. How to counteract the other person's style or what he's got, and hopefully try and win the fight.
Fighters, seconds out. Both fighters touch gloves. This is the third and final round.
Both boys center ring, give each other a hug before they finish, start off the third round. Nice push kick there by Dylan. Left hand.
Oh, he's nicely getting that rear leg up, but geez, doesn't Dylan just come forward? He just gets straight back into the action.
And if you look at those elbows in between the grappling, you know, there's just little nudges of the elbows. It's just enough to cut, as you can see there.
Oh, the 1-2 elbow from Braden Sam. Nicely done, but I tell you, Dylan does not let up on the knees. He's just getting that sneaky left elbow across every time, is Braden Sam.
And I tell you what, these two first fights so far, well matched by the man himself, Mark Jelsey.
You know, when you have fights like this early on the card with guys that are trying to, you know, cut their teeth and make their name, it really says something to the guys with more experience as we go into the main card to, you know, hey guys, we've done this and we're only just starting out. You guys better put on a show.
But then also too, John, imagine these guys after 10 to 15 fights. What they could do and how good they would be.
100%, mate. Absolutely. It really shows that kickboxing, Muay Thai, K1, it's in very good hands in Victoria at the moment.
Well, it goes back to the next maybe minute and a half to see who's going to take this fight out. Both boys aren't holding back. Oh, nice push kick to follow with a straight left.
Every time Dylan's thrown that straight left a treat tonight. It misses with the right hook. Dylan being the, once again, southpaw fighter. Jeez, it's a real great exchange of different styles, different techniques. Oh, nice step up knee by Braden Sam.
Another knee. I think he's hurt him.
Oh, he's hurt him. He's on the rubber legs. Here comes Braden Sam. The crowd's going wild here in a sold-out arena. Oh, the elbow exchange back. Joe Mader, here we go.
He's come back. I mean, you know, Braden came out with two beautiful knees in the elbow. Who rocked him? He thought he had him. You know, full credit to Dylan. He just came back and started holding his ground.
Final stage, the third and final round.
I think Dylan at the moment has to just lift a little bit more.
Oh yes, ladies and gentlemen, show your appreciation. Dylan Matola, Braden Sam. What a war.
What an awesome fight. Fight number two, and then, you know, what a great finish to a three-rounder.
Can I please have a representative from Line Studio to center ring?
They kept us all on the edge of our seats until the last second of that last round to see who's going to take it. I think the blue corner might just take it, and the reason why I say that is just that last 15, 20 seconds of all those knees and the elbows. It was, you know, great effort from both boys, but I think I'll just give it to the guy in the blue shorts or in the red corner. And fight number two was proudly sponsored by Line Studio.
August 7th, ladies and gentlemen, Prince Promotions is back in Altona. Come and see the man himself, Prince Bunjakul, take on the AK-47, Chris Bradford, in a heavyweight showdown like never before seen. It's going to hit like a truck.
Both boys now making their way to center ring to get the final decision. I think both boys should be proud of themselves, and the trainers should be proud of these boys, because I think they've put in a great effort and a great show.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, before I announce the winner of this fight, it's only second fight of the night, but what a performance by these two. Show your appreciation. Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we have gone to the judges' scorecard. All three judges had it going the same way, 29, 28, 29, 28, and 29, 28, declaring your winner, Brendan Saad.
Well, there you go, guys. Brendan Saad from ACSA, trained by Full Lay, takes out the victory. But you know, really, you know, Dylan, you've got to keep your head up high, mate. You've been fantastic. You've got a great performance. I'm sure those boys will come back stronger and better next time round. But you know, for a guy who's only had two fights, he's put on a fantastic display tonight.